Which English rock band had a 1970 hit with Paranoid?
Oh yeah, I know this. This actually ties back into, you can even tie it back to some other stuff we were talking about earlier. You know this one, right?
No. I'm too young for
You know the song
this,
Paranoid?
Man. I don't know.
Okay, there's an interesting story behind this. Oh my gosh. This is such a great one.
What's
I know,
the
I mean, do you guys know who it is?
No.
So it's Black Sabbath.
Black Sabbath.
So, yeah. Yep. So
I don't know much Black Sabbath.
Finish with my woman, cause she couldn't help me with my mind. People think I'm insane because I am frowning all the time.
Oh, yeah.
Paranoid.
Yep.
Now, okay. that album, so this is Black Sabbath's second album. Okay, so they had one right before that that was their self-titled one. Then they came out with this album, Paranoid. Now, fascinating thing about this album, Paranoid, it was originally supposed to be called War Pigs, which is which, you know the song War Pigs?
No.
Yes, you do.
They didn't do War Pigs.
Oh, no.
Hand me a guitar. Oh, my gosh. You guys know War, you guys have heard this before. Ready?
I like
this. Generals gathered in their masses. Just like witches at black masses. You know that song?
No.
That's War Pigs.
Oh. Okay.
Now, that was on.
I remember that?
Everything.
Politicians hide themselves away. Oh, it's a great tune. So anyway, so that album, Paranoid, was originally going to be called War Pigs, and it was that song. I mean, it is maybe their best song they ever did. I love that tune. Then Tony Iommi, who's the guitarist for Black Sabbath, had this. They needed another song on it. And he had this little kind of simple riff, and it was even in the same key as that song right there.
Mm-hmm.
And it was the one I started singing a second ago called Paranoid. Finish with my woman, cause she couldn't help me with my mind. And it was just this super ultra simple riff. They threw it on the album as kind of a last whatever thing, yeah. And. And it was kind of a throwaway tune. Everybody loved it. They decided it was going to be the hit. They changed the name from War Pigs to Paranoid. They changed the whole name of the album to Paranoid.
Wow.
That song came out, and it's still their quintessential, like maybe biggest song they ever put out. And it, which is weird because then I think the album cover like had this guy with a sword, which made War Pigs make more sense.
Yeah.
But then they took the name War Pigs and threw Paranoid on there and go, what the heck?
How does
you know, it doesn't really, yeah. It didn't match anymore. But anyway, Paranoid, that was the band, Black Sabbath, 1970.
Well, that's cool.
Yeah.
I wonder what they were thinking about when they came up with War Pigs and somebody with a...
It was a great, great album, though. The album was amazing.
Well,
at the time it was... You gotta keep
animals.
In mind, this was during the Vietnam War, too.
Oh,
this is in the middle of the Vietnam War. Well, and so, you know, they've got, you know, the lyrics, politicians hide themselves away. They only started the war. Why should they go out to fight? They leave that all to the poor.
Yeah
that's the lyric.
So that's
and it's that, it's that same
that.
Kind of thing,
mm-hmm.
You know, where they were, along there was that, there was that other song
we
that
bring it back now.
What's that?
We need to bring it back now.
Yeah. Well, there's the other tune by Creedence Clearwater Revival that had that same kind of, I ain't no fortunate son, I ain't no senator's son. And it was that same idea that, that the poor people are the ones that go fight the wars that the senators start.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And so that was a big theme back then. So Black Sabbath
that's
threw
cool.
that into. Yeah.
That's cool.
Great. That was a great album.